Good morning, Eagle Nation. It is Tuesday. It is the 174th day of school. It's the 18th of May. Wherever you may be, please stop, please stand, and let us rise for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. You may be seated. Hope you're dressed today in your black Emerson tee. Kindergarten, we're going to get you on board by Friday. But everybody else, you're going to be sporting your black today. And either way, we're going to be together in spirit and in solidarity today. As we celebrate this and kick off this 174th day of school, that was a song dedication that you just heard from Bastion. That was the song Phoenix by Fall Out Boy. It says, I would like to dedicate this song to everyone, but mainly to my class. Mr. L's, or Mr. Lovelady's classroom. Thank you, Bastion, for that song dedication. Thank you, Mr. L, for all you do for our students. And thank you, everyone, for just bringing energy to another day to get us through to the end. We can do this work. On this Tuesday, some big announcements coming your way. First, just a reminder, camps, we now have 27 different students enrolled in our summer camps and growing. We have room for at least 70, so we're not quite halfway there. If you haven't signed up yet and you're interested, sign up. It's a great opportunity. It's a unique opportunity. We'd love to have you if you're coming into the 4th grade, 5th, 6th, 7th, or 8th grade. For you 8th graders, we wish you well in high school. This is not an opportunity that's open to you. But we know you'll be going to the Freshman Academy because it's an important thing to do. And for you who are in kindergarten, 1st, 2nd, and 3rd grade, we know that many of you will be attending our summer school program. And we want to make sure that you get the support that you need this summer. So if you're in 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, or 8th grade, as of fall, in August of 2021, sign up for a club. You'll be glad you did. Excuse me, a camp. You'll be glad you did. Also, tomorrow's Wednesday, which means we're doing school tours here at Emerson at 9 a.m. and 5 p.m. So if you've got a family member, a friend, or a neighbor that you think might be interested in joining the Emerson family, have them come check us out. We'll give them a tour. They'll meet me as their principal. We'll also come and visit a primary, an intermediate, and a middle school classroom. And they'll get a chance to ask all the questions about cool clubs like mini med school and art club, piano club, and so much more. So have them check us out. The link is up above this video on the website. Plus, your parents will be getting a robocall tonight that also has that link for the tour. As we continue our celebration of Asian Pacific Heritage Month, today, as you know, is Trivia Tuesday. So I've got three questions for you today, and they are about the history, or some history, of Asian Americans here in the United States and our relationship between the East and the West. First question. Know your history. When did Chinese workers begin to build the Transcontinental Railroad? Seventh and eighth graders, I'm expecting you to know this. When did Chinese workers begin to build the Transcontinental Railroad? Was it A, 1865, B, 1910, or C, 1915? If you said 1865, you would be correct. The conclusion of the Civil War, Transcontinental Railroad was begun, and thousands upon thousands of Chinese workers immigrated from the East through the West and began working on that massive endeavor. Second question. What island was nicknamed Ellis Island of the West because it was a major immigrant processing station in the early part of the 20th century? Ellis Island of the West. Was it A, Goat Island, B, Angel Island, or C, Alcatraz Island? Goat Island, Angel Island, or Alcatraz Island? You have 5 seconds. All right, seventh and eighth graders, I'm counting on you again to know this one. If you said Angel Island, you would be correct. Third and final question, and then I'll share with you the link if you'd like to take the rest of this quiz and find out more. Each of these has not only the answer, but the history that goes along with it. Third and final question, who were the pensionados? Who were the pensionados? Were they A, Japanese American veterans from World War II who lobbied Congress for pension plans? Were they B, Filipino students who came to the United States to study medicine, agriculture, and other fields from 1903 to 1910? Or C, Asian American students who started the Yellow Power movement in the 1970s? Who were the pensionados? A, B, or C? You have 5 seconds. If you said B, Filipino students who came to the United States to study medicine, agriculture, and other fields from 1903 to 1910, you would be correct. Many of those students then returned to the Philippines shortly thereafter, and in the 1920s and 30s went on to develop medicine, agriculture, and other fields in their homeland, the Philippines. If you'd like to know more about that history, come check it out and the link below this. Take the quiz at the bottom, but follow that link and you can take the quiz. And if you're wondering what to do when you're done, as your teachers may allow you to do, take the quiz. And if you're interested to go even deeper, look up some of these things. You can look up pensionados and find out a history and see a variety of photographs of those just by doing a simple Google search. There's one such photo below this as well. It is PBIS Tuesday. We're going to continue being responsible this week. So today, our tip for you to be responsible is this. Advocate for what you need. This is your last chance to let your teachers know what you need before grades are entered and finalized. Be sure to let them know what you need. And with that, we conclude our morning announcements. So let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. Choices. Are you counting the days? Summer vacation is almost here. It's time for ice cream and swimsuits, bare feet, and summer fun. Just think about all that free time. We talked about it a little bit yesterday. What are you going to do with all that time? Well, here's our bulletin. We want you to use your time wisely. We want you to make wise choices. And because there will probably be more opportunities than usual to get into trouble, we want you to think carefully before you act and consider all the consequences of your actions. Remember these words from the French. From a short pleasure comes a long repentance. Or you could say from just a few moments of fun, you could have a long period of feeling ashamed and wishing you had made a wiser choice. This summer, make choices that you will be proud of. Don't risk a lifetime of regrets for a few moments of pleasure. There's something to think about, even if it's difficult to say. This is Mr. Lodato. Make it a great day or not. The choice is yours.